Hey guys, welcome to another very exciting tutorial of creation process, and this week we'll be making a professional logo. So like the earlier ones, but this one is much more unique. So let's begin. We'll take an ellipse tool, make a circle or pure rounded circle. Now take a rectangle tool and may draw it over it, and make sure that it's in the center of the circle. Like you can see, there is a mark here which shows that you are at the center. After that, select both the object, go to Pathfinder and just subtract it. Once you have done that, now draw one more circle with the ellipse tool, and inside that draw one more with this much of thickness. Now select both, subtract it, and use this as your handle. Small scale it down, put it here. Now select both and combine it. Change its color to maybe light gray, and reduce its opacity by going into transparency and keep it around 70%. Once you've done that, after that, you can take another ellipse tool, make it this much big, and it's change its color to red. Let's keep it red. It's pink, just keep it red, pure red. Now after that, just move this aside with the ellipse tool. Just make a small circle at this corner, this much. Make it change its color to black. Now using the rotate tool, keep its anchor point to the center here of this main circle, and click and drag with clicking the Alt key in your keyboard, and just duplicate multiple number of times by clicking Ctrl D. And after that, when you have done that, select all of them, select Shape Builder tool, and just subtract these portions. You all already know that how to use this Shape Builder tool. I have already made a video on this last week. So now after you've done that, select all the circles, small ones, select all of them, and delete it. You got a cool design. Now, before that, we need to do one more thing. Now, after you have done this design, take the ellipse tool, draw it in the center, give some boundary. Maybe black, so that you can see it properly. Control C, Control F, scale it down. Control C, Control F, scale it down. Control C, Control F, one more time. After you've done that, select all of them, go to Shape Builder tool, select this and this, and after that just delete it out, and you got a design. Now remove the outlines by selecting the object, or just group it, Control G. Now select the object and remove its outline, and what we need to do is we need to put it here. Make sure it's in the center, scale it up, just scale it down a little bit, and we'll make one more rectangle over it here from this center. Now select this and this rectangle, go to Shape Builder again. The Shape Builder is a very important cool tool. You can use it anywhere, like the Pathfinder tool. After you have separated this and this, just deselect it and delete the portion which you don't need, and select the lower portion of this machine. Change its color to dark gray. So after you've done that, scale it down. Make sure you have removed all the outlines from here, and we need to add few more steps. Now we will use spiral tool. It might be new for you, so I'll tell you how to use it. After selecting the spiral tool, just click on the blank portion. You get an option spiral. You need to adjust the radius. I have kept 100, delay 70%, and segments, how many segments you need. So I have put it 5 and click OK. Now add the outline, means the border, and adjust the change the thickness to around 14 and change its color to maybe a little more lighter gray, and change its angle. Now go to reflect tool, double click on it to make sure it's vertically. Preview it. You can preview it by clicking here and just click OK. Once you have done that, just scale it up a bit. Select all of them and scale it on little smalls because it's taking almost all the areas. So scale it up a bit, change its angle. Now duplicate it, Alt and click drag, scale it up. Just scale it on little small and change its angle to make sure that it's like parallel to it. And after that, just go to this independent direct selection tool, delete the anchor points from the second portion, and just do a few more adjustment here. If you feel that's more concave, you can edit it. Okay, once you have done that, select both of them. Make sure their thickness is equal. Scale it down. Rotate it. Keep it in the center. Let's give more thickness, 14. And keep it over there. Now take the text, your logo name. I kept it CR Beyond Carbon COFFE Coffee. I thought this name is cool, and just gave it color gray and keep it over it. So this is how you can make a professional logo in a slightly different way. So I hope you like this video. And thank you.